Well, welcome to All Saints Community Church, everybody. We're here Palm Sunday in our underground church. It's great to have you at church. And as you can see, I'm behind the altar today because we're going to have a procession. And I hope that you've got your palm leaves made out as I sent them out to you. And don't forget, you need your bread and wine later on for our communion. So why don't we begin the service? We're technically starting outside. I'm going to ask you to please stand. And as I say to you, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Now you'll see a slide of Jesus entering into Jerusalem, and people are placing their palm branches down on the ground in front of him. So here we go. Take your palm leaves and wave them as we process. So I'm going to process from here out, and I'm going to ask Jenny to come and help us sing our processional song.
So our first song is especially for the children. Clap your hands and sing to the Lord. And it's a COVID-19 one as well, because at the end we're singing Wash Your Hands and Sing to the Lord. So please dance around, clap, snap your fingers. Let's sing to the Lord.
Approach this Palm Sunday season, let me read these words to you. Dear friends in Christ, during Lent we have been preparing for the celebration of our Lord's Paschal mystery. On this day our Lord Jesus Christ entered the holy city of Jerusalem in triumph. The people welcomed him with palms and shouts of praise, but the path before him led to self-giving, suffering, and death. Today we greet him as our King, although we know his crown is thorns and his throne a cross. We follow him this week from the glory of the palms to the glory of the resurrection by way of the dark road of suffering and death. United with him in his suffering on the cross, may we share his resurrection and new life. Let's invite Jenny to come and lead us as we sing together.
We're going to sing Lord Most High. And there's an echo part, so I'll sing the first part, or you can join that too, I won't know. And then there's an echo too, so I'll try and help with the echo a little bit.
Thank you. love you, Lord.
And now let the weak say,
Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Well, it's time to welcome everybody and our visitors. So, hands up if this is your first time to All Saints Community Church. Well, for some of us, this is the second time. It's great to have you at church. And if you're watching for the first time, welcome to All Saints Community Church. It's just great to have you here. Now, normally we have a joy time. And today we've got some extra special joy time pictures. So you're going to see on the screen right now four pictures. The first two, this is the first one, is Joy Lynn with her mum and dad in a backyard with Jesus entering Jerusalem. And they've got all these branches that they're throwing in front of the procession coming into Jerusalem. And here's a second picture of Joy Lynn and her family telling the story of Jesus processing into Jerusalem. And the third picture we have here is of Anya. Anya made a picture of the sun and the path. And you'll see the little palm branches and all the grey spots are the people lining up the path and the sun shining down the path and the little buildings. And there's God right in the middle. And God is holding the sun as a story of the triumphal entry. And then Aidan has drawn a picture of a palm tree. So fantastic, Aidan and Anya and Joy Lynn. Thank you for sharing those pictures with us. And you can go and wave your palm branches if you like while we're getting ready to do our Bible reading. So today we're going to read the story of Jesus entering into Jerusalem. And because it's a gospel reading, I'm going to ask if you would please stand and we'll read this scripture together. After Jesus had said this, he went on ahead, going up to Jerusalem. As he approached Bethpage and Bethany at the hill called the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go to the village ahead of you, and as you enter it, you will find a colt tied there, which no one has ever ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, 'Why are you untying it?' tell him, 'The Lord needs it.'" Those who were sent ahead went and found it just as he had told them. As they were untying the colt, its owners asked them, "Why are you untying the colt?" And they replied, "The Lord needs it." He brought it to Jesus. They brought it to Jesus, threw their cloaks on the colt and put Jesus on it. As he went along, people spread their cloaks on the road. When he came near the place where the road goes down the Mount of Olives, the whole crowd of disciples began joyfully to praise God in loud voices for all the miracles they'd seen. "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest." Some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, rebuke your disciples." "I tell you," he replied, "if they keep quiet, the stones will cry out." This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, before you sit down, let me say an opening prayer and I'll get you to sit after that. Father God, thank you for this scripture and we pray that you would speak to us today in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you. Do please be seated. So what I'd like to do is share with you a thought today about this Bible reading and maybe what we can learn for the days ahead. Who would ever have thought that I would be preaching a sermon from the basement of my home in this underground church? But the worship continues and God's people continue together in whatever ways they can. Now, we've heard a lot about how we should prepare ourselves and conduct ourselves during the spread of this virus. Yes, social distancing, washing your hands, isolation, limit your outings. However, you know, we've heard only a very little, if anything, about how we should conduct ourselves spiritually during the spread of this virus. Well, I want to give you some spiritual advice. And so the title of my sermon today is Spiritual Virology. Here you have a picture of a virus, and I want to talk to you about the spirituality of how we should deal in times of a virus. And maybe Jesus has got something to teach us. This is the day that we remember the last week in the life of Jesus. And so it's Sunday morning as Jesus enters Jerusalem. And I thought it'd be interesting to see this account of the triumphal entry, and maybe it might have something to say to us during this time of world crisis. It's pretty interesting when you think about the fact that Jesus took a risk and came to the planet to send us, bring us good news, let us know the kingdom is near. And he risked getting a virus and leprosy and everything else, and he came to us. In Luke 19, verse 28, after Jesus had been talking to his disciples, he went ahead going up to Jerusalem. And we see now that Jesus gives his disciples a series of instructions. So the first instruction, Jesus tells us what to do. As he approached Bethany and Bethpage, at the hill called the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go to the village ahead of you, and as you enter it, you'll find a colt tied there, which no one has ever ridden. Untie it and bring it here." So the first thing we see in this story is that Jesus gave the disciples some instructions. You know what? It's always good if you do what he tells you to do. As we navigate these uncertain days and all the messages of the world that we're getting, I want to suggest to you that it's really, really good that you do what Jesus tells you to do. There's a great principle in Proverbs chapter 3 and verse 5. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Don't lean on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to him, and he'll make your path straight. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and shun evil. So here's the first thing. If you submit everything you do to God, he'll show you exactly what he wants you to do. His instructions are always good. Look, when he was talking to the fishermen as he was recruiting his disciples, he said, "Come, follow me, and I'll make you fishers of men." That's not a bad thing. Follow Jesus. He told them a story. He said to them, "You're the light of the world. In the same way, let your light shine before others." That's Matthew 5:16. Matthew chapter 6 and verse 33. "Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all of these things will be added to you as well." What about John 14:21? "Whoever has my commands and keeps them loves me." Look, here's the point. During these uncertain days, whether you go out shopping once a week or twice a week and how many meters you keep between each other, that's all good. But I want to suggest to you that the other thing we want to do is always do what Jesus tells you to do. Always do what Jesus tells you to do. That's the way we're going to survive these next few days and weeks and months. And he'll look after us if you do what he tells you to do. Well, the second thing that we notice from this passage, that Jesus also instructs the disciples what to say. In verse 31 of Luke 19, he says, "If anyone asks you, why are you untying it? Tell them, the Lord needs it." And those who were sent ahead found it just as he had told them. And as they were untying the colt, its owner said, "Why are you untying the colt?" And they replied, "Well, the Lord needs it." See, not only did Jesus tell the disciples what to do, he also told them what to say. The Lord needs it. It's really good practice if you think about saying the things that Jesus wants you to say, as well as doing the things that he wants you to do. Look at Paul's advice to the Colossians in Colossians 3, verse 17. "Whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him." The parable of the wedding feast, he sent his servants to those who'd been invited, "Tell them to come." That's another thing that we're to do, is tell the world to come and meet Jesus and learn about the spiritual principles of life. And when he delivered a demon-possessed man in Mark chapter 5 and verse 19, the demon-possessed man wanted to go with Jesus, and Jesus said to him, "Go home to your own people and tell them how much the Lord has done for you and how he's had mercy on you." That's another thing that you and I could do, is go and tell the people how much the Lord has done for us. So you see, in this story, we see that Jesus is giving us advice of things that we can say. When he was preparing his 72 disciples, he said to them, "Go heal the sick and tell them that the kingdom of God is near." Well, that's another thing that we can do during this epidemic, is let people know that the kingdom of God is near. And then another example, when after the resurrection, Jesus told Mary Magdalene, she wanted to hug him, and he said, "No, look, go tell my brothers," that's the disciples, "that I'm ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." One of the things that we can tell people is that this God is our God. He's my God and he's your God. You see, doing the things that Jesus tells us to do and saying the things that Jesus tells us to say are a way for us to navigate the world in which we live. So here's a slide. Always say what Jesus tells you to say. See these little kids telling secrets. Always say what Jesus tells you to say. Now, when you obey God, when you obey Jesus, you're going to find two results, or at least two. Here are the results of doing and saying what Jesus tells you to do and say. We read in verse 45 of Luke 19, "They brought the animal to Jesus, threw their cloaks on the colt, and put Jesus on it. As he went along, people spread their cloaks on the road. When he came near the place where the road goes down the Mount of Olives, the whole crowd of disciples began joyfully to praise God in loud voices for all the miracles they had seen." You see, what happens when you do what Jesus tells you to do and you say what Jesus tells you to say, you'll see the result is people worship. Here, verse 38 of Luke 19, "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest." When you obey Jesus in word and deed, the result is praise and honor. You recognize his kingship. He's the King of Kings. He's the Lord of Lords. He's the Lord of every virus, every sickness. He's absolutely in control. And if you recognize his kingship and his lordship, you'll remind yourself again that he's in charge. He's in charge of the whole universe. Peace in heaven and glory in earth, on earth. That leads to peace in us. We can navigate these times with peace in our hearts. You do what he tells you to do, you say what he tells you to say, and you'll discover that through worship, you'll find peace in your heart. And so we can say, your will be done on earth as it already is in heaven. You see, here's a slide that I want to show you. Obedience leads to worship. You see that man there kneeling, worshiping God. Now there's another side to this too that you need to be aware of. Verse 39, some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, rebuke your disciples." And Jesus said, "I tell you, if they keep quiet, the stones will cry out." You see, if you obey Jesus, if you do what he wants you to do and you say what he wants you to say, you will get resistance. Religious people rebuked his disciples. Someone will rebuke you, me, the disciples. Someone will want to stop you doing what Jesus wants you to do. Somebody will stop you from saying what Jesus wants you to say. They won't like it. Because when you talk about God, that may threaten them, that may feel them, make them uncomfortable. Maybe they don't want to discuss the issue of God. But Jesus said that even if people stopped talking, the stones would speak about him. And history has proven that you can't stop people obeying Jesus. You can't stop people doing what he tells them to do and saying what he tells them to say. And the harder people try to stop the message, the more persistent the gospel message becomes. And so as Captain Picard discovered in Star Trek when he was battling the Borg, that resistance is futile. You cannot stop the gospel. So let me say in closing that as you navigate the world that we have to survive in now, and we do all this social isolating and keeping all the rules that the government's required of us, I want you to think about spiritual virology. How to understand how to navigate a spirit of fear and anxiety as this virus takes over the world. Two things. Do what Jesus tells you to do, and say what Jesus tells you to say. And if you do that, you'll find that the result of obeying Jesus is worship and peace. Now, you'll get some resistance as well, but that's futile. The gospel will continue to grow and develop. And so I pray that during these next few weeks and months, that you'll consider these words, do what he tells you, say what he says, and you'll experience the peace of God, which doesn't make any sense to many people. I pray that you'll see this in Jesus' name. Amen. Now I'm going to ask Jenny if she would come and lead the prayers of the people. Thanks, Jenny.
So when I say, "Lord, in your mercy," please respond with, "Hear our prayer." So let's try it and practice now. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we are blessed to be called your children. Every day with you is a gift, whether on this earth or with you in eternity. Thank you for the exceptional care we receive from you each day. Thank you for your promise of provision as we seek your kingdom and your righteousness. How great you are. How faithful you are. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, you are light. There is no darkness in you. There is no duplicity. We are the ones with divided hearts and divided loyalties. Your word says we cannot have fellowship with you if we conceal our sin. So, Lord, send the searchlight of your Holy Spirit into our lives and expose our sin, the sin that grieves you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We thank you, Lord, that your word also says if we confess our sins rather than conceal them, you are faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. We want nothing to hinder our walk with you, Lord. Forgive us for not seeking you first and renew our first love for you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Now we pray for our Queen and our Prime Minister and ask that you would cause them to humble their hearts before you. Give them wisdom in these days and place people around them who will bring them encouragement. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Again, today we remember all the doctors, nurses, first responders, grocery store workers, and all those who are serving and caring for our communities. We thank you for them all, Lord. Bless them, protect them, heal them, and may they find their hope in you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O Lord God, we ask you to heal those who are suffering from ill health. Comfort and strengthen those who are struggling with mental health issues, especially in these times of isolation. May they find their hope in you. Lord, cause family and friends to reach out to them, and may their reaching out be received as an act of love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, there are many who are feeling extremely lonely at this time because of the need to stay at home. Come and touch them. Bring them your peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We lift before you our family members and those out in the community who do not yet know the joy of following and serving you. Please mention the names of your loved ones and your friends and neighbors. May they hear your invitation to follow above the din of this world. May they have a revelation of who you are and who they are before you. Thank you that Jesus came into the world to be the Savior of the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father, all these prayers we bring before you in the mighty and precious name of Jesus, your Son. Amen.
Amen. Well, even in times like this, we can have peace. This is a gift from God to us. So I'm going to ask you to please stand. And as you do, I say to you, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Now go share that peace with those around you. And if you're by yourself, give yourself a big hug as well. Peace be with you. Thank you. You may be seated. Okay, now for our announcements, just got a couple of things to let you know. The first announcement is our community lunch. You can see that up on the screen now. And after our service on April the 19th, we're going to log into Zoom. You'll get an invitation. And at 12 noon, I want you to bring your lunch around your computer, and we're going to have a Zoom lunch, a community lunch all together. 12 o'clock, Sunday, April the 19th. And I'll give you more news about push prayer as we do that through Zoom. You'll see that as well, and you'll get emails from us. And I also want to tell you about Holy Week at All Saints. We have three services in Holy Week that's coming up now. Maundy Thursday, a Eucharistic service at 7 p.m. Good Friday, we're going to have a Good Friday service. Just note that there's no service for the Peninsula Network at Softball City. Just a Good Friday service at our church at 11 online. And then Easter Sunday, 10:30 for our Easter Sunday service. And so we look forward to you joining us. Now we want to come and share birthdays and anniversaries. It's the first Sunday of the month. And so I wrote to you and asked you, if you're having a birthday or anniversary, would you please come, send me a note and let me know that you're having a birthday and an anniversary. So I've got a few notes here. Bob and Emmy are celebrating their 68th wedding anniversary. Congratulations to Bob and Emmy. Janice Inch is having a birthday in April, and so is Rosalia. And Jean, who's living up in Nelson, BC, who was part of our church for quite a long time as well while she was down here. She's having her birthday in April. Birthday greetings to you. And George, he's having his, George and Christina celebrating their 57th wedding anniversary in April. So to all the birthdays and anniversaries, God bless you. Let's say a prayer and a blessing for your birthdays and anniversaries. Father God, we thank you for birthdays and anniversaries. We pray your blessing on these couples, on their marriages and on their birthdays. We thank you for the life you've given them. Give them health as they navigate the days forward, many more years of life. And we thank you for these rhythms that we celebrate with you. We ask your blessing on them in Jesus' name. And all the people said,
Amen.
Thank you. Well, we're going to just give you details about our offering. And we're still working on online giving. So hopefully pretty soon we'll have that ready and you'll get information. But in the meantime, don't stop sending your checks in the mail, and you can see the address up on the screen, the address for our mailbox, All Saints Community Church, P.O. Box 75068 White Rock, and that's in Surrey, BC, V4A0B1. Please do keep sending your checks and support, tithes and offerings, because we still want to support the community and keep our church going. So thank you for that. God bless you. Now, let's come to the blessing of the palms. So you can see that we have these palms here, and I hope that you've got your palms at home as well. So I want you to raise them, and we're going to ask God to bless them. Now, normally we would have real palm fronds that Carolyn and Bill would fold up. Well, we can't do that at the moment, but we can take these palms as a blessing from God. And so I say to you as we pray this prayer together, I'll say the first part and you say amen. Bless, O Lord, we pray, these branches of palm to those who receive them, that both now and in the days to come, they may be a memorial of your passion and a pledge of your victory over sin and death for the glory of your great name.
Amen.
So while I prepare the altar, I want you to go and get your bread and your wine, and we will celebrate communion together. Okay, if you've got your bread and your wine, let's say this communion together. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Loving God, we thank you for this world of wonder and delight. You have given it to us to care for so that all your creatures may enjoy its bounty. Lord our God,
we give you thanks and praise.
And so, with everyone who believes in you, with all the saints and angels, we rejoice and praise you, saying the same thing the disciples did when Jesus entered into Jerusalem. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. And now we thank you for these gifts of bread and wine. May we who receive them, as Jesus said, share his body and his blood. On the night that he was betrayed, he took bread, gave you thanks, and he broke the bread, and he gave it to his friends and said, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks, and he shared the cup with them and said, "This is my blood poured out so that sins may be forgiven. Do this as often as you do it in remembrance of me." And so we respond with this age-old anthem as we say together, Christ has died, Christ has risen, and Christ will come again. We who are many are one body, for we all share in the one bread. And Lord, you taught us to hope for salvation, the joy of every longing heart. And so we pray for the coming of your kingdom, in the words our Saviour taught us, as we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And so I say to you, these are the gifts of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Well, I want you to go and take the bread now, as we've consecrated that, and you share the bread amongst yourselves. And take the wine and share that amongst yourselves as well. Blood of Christ shed for you. And while you're sharing your communion, let's get Jenny to come and sing a song for us as we just contemplate what we've just done and what we're doing.
In the morning when I rise, in the morning when I rise, in the morning when I rise, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, you can have all this world, but give me Jesus. When I am alone, oh, and when I am alone, when I am alone, give me Jesus. Jesus, give me Jesus. You can have all this world, but give me Jesus. When I come to die, oh, and when I come to die, when I come to die, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, give me Jesus. You can have all this world, you can have all this world, you can have all.
Amen. Thank you, Jenny. Well, it's great that we could be together to do church. And as we come to the end of our service, let me say this prayer for you. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace, and opened the gate of glory. And together we say, may we who share Christ's body, riz his risen life, we who drink his cup, bring life to others, we whom the Spirit lights, give light to the world. Keep us in this hope that we have grasped, so we and all your children shall be free and the whole earth live to praise your name. Amen. And for our blessing, would you please stand as we always do, you know, in our community, we point to the cross three times. We point to the cross for this blessing. And the fourth time, we raise our hands in hope. So as you're standing, I say to you, all our problems
we send to the cross of Christ.
And all our difficulties
we send to the cross of Christ.
And all the devil's works
we send to the cross of Christ.
And all our hopes we set on the risen Christ. So as you go on your way this week, I want you to think about what we've done today and what we've celebrated and the palms that we have blessed, and I want you to carry these palms with you, maybe put them in your room or whatever. And remember the words of Jesus as he has taught us when he went into Jerusalem. He taught his disciples not only do what he tells them to do, but say what he tells them to say. And remember that the results of that will be people will praise God, and some people will resist too. But you go and do what he tells you to do and say what he tells you to say. And the final blessing, before we sing our final song. Be on your guard. Stand firm in the faith. Be bold. Be courageous. Do everything with love. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest on you and those you love, now and forever. Amen. Let's remain standing as we sing our final song. Worshipping with us today. Let me blow out the candles. And I say to you, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And as we leave, you'll see up on the screen the slides for Holy Week. See you Maundy Thursday, Good Friday, and Easter Sunday. God bless you. See you next week.